Good evening. Thanks very much. Welcome to the 4th annual Northern Roots Festival evening concert. Glad to see you all here. We have a really wonderful evening of music coming up, and for many of you, it's a big day of music already behind you. I hope a lot of you managed to get out and enjoy some of the great teaching workshops that we had here in the theater, some of the performances that we had here during the day, and of course there were sessions through the afternoon at McNeil's Pub. We're very grateful to McNeil's once again for opening their doors to us. So, thank you. The festival has grown over the course of the past 4 years, and this year took a very large step forward, I would say. We're really at capacity here. We're sold out tonight. We're going to be selling advance tickets to next year's concert in the intermission. So it's been really wonderful kind of seeing the festival grow and develop over the past few years, and that's been due in no small part to a wonderful committee of friends and local musicians who have helped in the planning and the running of the festival. And I'll just name those people: Corey DeMario and Lissa Schneckenberger, Mary Lee, Rebecca Lay. I'll just say them all: Rebecca Lay, Louisa Pugh, Amanda Whitman, Roger Kale, Brendan Taff, Dan Houghton, and Becky Tracy. We're all part of this great committee, so give them a big hand, please. As I'm sure you know, the Northern Roots Festival is an activity of the Brattleboro Music Center, which has thrown its enthusiasm and support behind a wonderful traditional music program throughout the year. And this past summer, we ran some summer programs, but the Northern Roots Festival is really kind of a centerpiece now of the traditional music program. So we're very grateful to everybody at the BMC who's worked with us: Sabine and Lanny and Betsy Immergut, who was also part of the organizing committee. But special mention goes to Pam Lyerly, who's working as we speak, seating people. But Betsy, yes. Pam, of course, is responsible for all of our publicity and our wonderful graphics that you see in the posters. Pam was just an amazing person with incredible patience and attention to detail. And I'm sure that without Pam, today something terrible would have gone wrong. You know, there would have been no chairs in the theater, or we all would have come on the wrong night, or something awful would have happened. But thanks to Pam, everything has run very smoothly. So thanks. As a music festival, of course, we also rely on excellent music, which we have had in great store. So, you know, the festival is a great opportunity for us to sort of showcase the amazing talent that we have here in Brattleboro in the traditional music community. We're very happy about that. And we're also delighted to have a number of musicians playing, particularly tonight, who are from out of town. And a lot of these players, they're not just people, anonymous people that we found online, you know, in chat rooms somewhere. These are players who have been connected to musicians here in Brattleboro. Many of these out-of-town players are people who have played with local musicians over the years. They're friends of ours, collaborators. So it's also a wonderful aspect of the festival that we get to bring these friends in here to town and to share kind of what we have here in Brattleboro. So we're very grateful to all of them. And sort of as a way of kind of underlining this great connection that we have to these other wonderful players from elsewhere in the region, tonight we're going to have actually some of our local musicians come up to the mic here, and different local players are going to actually introduce the acts as we go. So this will be the last time you see me for a little while. So I'm going to pass the mic over to another local musician to introduce the first act. This is a musician I've loved her music for a long time. I've followed her career very closely. I have all of her CDs, and I'm going to welcome out Becky Tracy.
Hi. Good evening. He has all my CDs in the basement. It's my great pleasure to introduce Sarah Blair to the stage. Sarah's a friend of mine and a colleague, and I have greatly admired her playing for years and years. And she just told me tonight that she was introduced to Irish fiddling from Jimmy Devine. Jimmy Devine was the person who opened the door for her, as she said, back in 1989. And boy, are we glad that he did. So welcome, Sarah Blair.
This is Owen Marshall, who's very kindly come out to play along with me. You're going to get to see him later as well. So those were a couple of slip jigs. One is called Barney Brannigan, and one is called Ride a Mile. And I couldn't tell you which one is which. I think I actually would probably have less than a 50% chance of being right if I tried to guess. Okay, so now we're going to play some reels with a little special, unusual treat in the middle. The first one is called Miss Monahan, and the second one is called Top It Off, and the last one is called The Spike Island Lasses. And I just found out recently that Spike Island was a women's prison. Yeah, so the Spike Island Lasses were probably not all that happy.
Way top of 2 minutes.
I know. Well, it is kind of a moody tune, so here we go.
Thank you.
Thanks. Thanks a lot. Thank you. So this is Ellie Marshall, who I've known since she was really, really young, even younger than she is now. So she was also kind enough to come out, and we're going to play two more things, the three of us. These two are brother and sister, as I'm sure everyone knows. It's like every parent's dream that your children grow up and play music together. Okay, so we're going to play a waltz called The Forlorn Queen. It wasn't originally a waltz, it was an Irish air of some kind that our friend Mark Roberts, which I know some of you are familiar with, a musician from Massachusetts, turned into this waltz that we played with a group called The Sevens. We used to play that tune together, so we're going to do that now. Papa Berenstain. Thanks a lot. Let's play that again. I like that. So we'll play one more thing. We'll play a set of reels. And the first one is called Sean Franks, and it's a tune I learned from Jimmy Devine, as a matter of fact. And then we're going to play a tune called
The Dogs
Among the Bushes. I'm sorry. Go ahead, really. The Dogs Among the Bushes. And then another animal tune, Bear Island, which is actually about bears. It's B-E-A-R-E, I guess. And it was a great pleasure to play for you, and hope you enjoy the rest of the concert. I know you will. All right, so we'll get this going, yeah. ¶¶ Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Owen.
Hello, my name is Andy Davis. I'm very proud to be introducing the next act. I spend a lot of my life surrounded by younger folks, singing, playing tunes, dancing. So this next group represents a part of the Northern Roots Festival that's very central, which is passing these traditions on. I think it was Dewey Balfa, the great Cajun musician, who said, "No tradition, every tradition, no matter how old, has to be passed on one generation at a time." So this next group is 17, count them, 17 young musicians, ages 8 to 16. Here they come. Let me tell you a little bit more about them. They're from New Hampshire, Vermont, Massachusetts. And their fearless leader, Jesse Gagne-Hall. This is a bit of an experiment with the internet, which we know is a very powerful force in the world. Put some tunes online. The players could go there, learn the tunes. They've been practicing all of a couple times today. So this is, you're about to witness the power of internet practice. And they're going to be playing two tunes. The first one is called The Wren, and the second one is The Dancing Bear by Bob McQuillan. So please make welcome Trad and Rad. Thank you.
Well, I'm here to introduce our next performer, but this is a story that began about 40 years ago. And I think I've known Jeff since 1969 or 70, something like that. He was fortunate enough that his parents were out on a quest to try and meet as many of the great singers of traditional songs in this country as they could and to record them. And so he grew up with recordings and with his dad, particularly singing a lot of their songs as he went around performing. I'm talking about Frank Warner. Frank and Ann Warner have one of the best collections of traditional songs that are to be found. And I highly recommend the book that Jeff, was it you and Garrett that edited that book?
No, just me.
It was just Jeff. Garrett makes films. And is also a wonderful singer. But I remember one time, Joan Roberts and I were at a singing camp down somewhere near New York City, and Jeff and Garrett sang this song, and it sounded for all the world. We were very excited because we thought, ooh, an American version of that song that Peter Bellamy sings, which must be an English version of the song. And then we found out that that Jeff's parents had collected the song and that Peter had changed it and made it sound English. So we were going to learn it. Anyway, the things that I really learned from Jeff were actually, the major thing was playing wiffle ball. And he's a vicious wiffle ball player. But when it comes time for the next generation to figure out how to sing the traditional songs, wonderful American traditional songs that there are, the way they're going to do it is they're going to go and listen to Jeff and they're going to say, oh, that's the way you do it. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure to introduce Jeff Warner.
So merry, so merry our way. No mortal on earth is as happy as we. Hi dery, hi dery, ho dery down. Give a shanty boy grog, there's nothing goes wrong.
It's the chorus. Woof, it's a lot of chorus, but I trust you.
So merry, so merry, so merry our way. No mortal on earth is as happy as we. Hi dery, ho dery, hi dery down. Give a shanty boy grog, there's nothing goes wrong. A for the axes, which we all know. B for the boys, which use them also. C for the chopping, which then does begin. D for the dangers we often are in. So merry, so merry, so merry our way. No mortal on earth is as happy as we. Hi dery, ho dery, hi dery down. Give a shanty boy grog, there's nothing goes wrong. E for the ixos that through the woods ring. F for the foreman, the head of our gang. G for the grindstone we grind the axe on. H for the handle so smoothly worn. I for the irons we stamp on the pines. J for the jolly boys always on time. K for the keen edge on the axes we keep. L for the lice which on us do creep. So merry, so merry, so merry are we. No mortal on earth is as happy as we. Hi dery, ho dery, hi dery down. Give a shanty boy grog, there's nothing goes wrong. M for the moss that chinks our camps. N for the needles that mend our old pants. O for the owls that hoot through the night. P for the pines we fell in daylight. Q for the quarreling we never allow. R for the rivers, the logs they do plow. S for the sleds, so stout and so strong. T for the teams that haul us so long. So merry, so merry, so merry are we. No mortal on earth is as happy as we. Hi dairy, ho dairy, hi dairy down. Give a shanty boy grog, there's nothing goes wrong. U for the uses we put our teams through. B for the valleys, the logs we haul through. W the woods we leave in the spring. And now I have sung nearly all that I'll sing. X for Christmas when the yarding's all done. Y for yonder, the set of the sun. Z for zero in the cold winter time. Now we have set all these letters to rhyme. Oh, merry, so merry, so merry are we. No mortal on earth is as happy as we. Hi, dairy, ho, dairy, hi, dairy down. Give a shanty boy grog, there's nothing goes wrong.
Now, I thought I'd do some lumbering songs here from our great Northeast, whether it's Maritimes or upstate New York, where a lot of my folks got their logging songs, or New Hampshire, where I live now. Thanks for letting us come over here. Now that we are a red state again, I wasn't sure. I thought there might be border patrol, but we came in easily this morning from Portsmouth. Interesting, living in New Hampshire now, you can get used to paying no sales tax and no income tax, but it's kind of a no tax, no service state, and as we say, live, freeze, and die over there. You can come on over, visit, but I wouldn't. But what a great logging history we have there. So this is a song collected by Gene Roberts Foster at the beginning of the 20th century, with a tune by Dan Berggren recently, professor at SUNY Buffalo, Fredonia, actually. And the chorus, the refrain is a lot easier. It says, "My girl's waiting for me," one of the many songs about the hardships of trying to do the river drives before they started using trucks in the 1930s. It's the other, of course, the other use of the word shanty that we hear. I guess you got that by now. It's not sea songs, but rather where the guys lived all winter long as they cut down the trees. Driving on the sack and dog, floating on them slippery logs, sleeping in the frozen bog. My girl's waiting for me. Hard-boiled eggs three times a day. Wet as beavers, we hit the hay. Not much sleep, but great good pay. Girls waiting for me. Big French Joe and I went out to break the jam when the logs gave out. Prene guard, he gave a shout. My girl's waiting for me. Big French Joe, the logs drowned him. He had no chance for to fight nor swim. When the logs drove up to the river's brim, my girl's waiting for me.
His girl comes to me and cries, well, if he's dead, then I shall die. Ma petite, he used to sigh, my girl's waiting for me. We will find him down below, around the bend where the water is slow, floating with his pike in tow. My girl's waiting for me. Ma petite will wring her hands as we scrape away at the yellow sand and bury him by the river strand. My girl's waiting for me. One more night and one more day, and the logs will reach the river bay, and I'll skin off these togs and I will say, my girl's waiting for me.
There's a museum up in the Adirondack Mountains, Blue Mountain Lake, that's all about the logging and its history and about the guys who did the jobs. It's an amazing education. And I was up there a few years ago looking up some stuff and came across this epitaph, which was so amazing to me. I've always been charmed, amazed by epitaphs that can be amusing, but probably didn't mean to be, but you know, things like, here lies Samantha Jones. In her last years, she was known for her virtue and sobriety. And I saw one once that said, she lived with her husband for 50 years and died in the sure hope of a better life. What was going on as they wrote that? But this one was great. It was a reprint from an 1880 newspaper. The epitaph supposedly said, here lies a woman who always was tired, who lived in a house where help was not hired. In her last days on earth, she said, friends, I'm a-going where cooking ain't done, nor washing, nor sewing. And everything's always just to my wishes, because they don't eat, there's no doing dishes. Don't weep for me now, don't weep for me never, because I'm doing nothing forever and ever. They must have had to write small, you know, to get all that on there, but they did. These are concertinas I'm playing, English concertinas. And I thought I'd put two songs together from the Ontario lumber camps. First one from a guy named O.J. Abbott. I worked up there and came over to America in about 1900. And another one from Jim Doherty, which is a reworking in the lumber camps of an English song called Jack Tar. But anyway, two songs from Ontario lumber camps. I am a jovial shanty boy. I love to sing and dance. I wonder what the girls would say if they could see my pants. 15 patches on the front and 16 on the stern. I wear them while I'm in the woods and home I do return. I'm on my jovial way and I'll spend my money free. I have plenty come and drink lager beer with me. I love the girls of the Gatineau, they are so trim and neat. They are so slim around the waist, their kisses are so sweet. There's handsome Jane and Mary Ann and fair young Betsy too. Along with one of the Gatineau girls, I'll roam this country through. I'm on my jovial way and I'll spend my money free. I have plenty come and drink lager beer with me. I often go out dancing, I dance all night, you see.
Often all the girls, they grow very fond of me. I dance all night till the morning light, I dance until the dawn. Head and tail up like a steer running through the corn. I'm on my jovial way and I'll spend my money free. I have plenty, come and drink lager beer with me.
Well, I'll end with this. We did a song this morning in the singing class. It was great fun, the whole class was. And I threatened to do this again tonight, so we've got some ringers who will remember the chorus. I learned it in the 80s when I was working in Ohio, and I found myself around Millersburg, which is the south central eastern part of Ohio, and found out it was the largest Amish community in America. I didn't even know they sang, they did, and I met two sisters, Mary and Emma Yoder, who were from the town of Charm, Ohio. You know, you drive down the town, it's down the street, it's like 18th century. It's just farms and no electricity and all. You get to the end of the street and there's the elementary school, and what does it say on it? Charm School, right there. In any case, they sang it, and they sang it nice and slow and sweet, and that's the way I like it. They call it Beautiful Life, which never enters into the text of the song, but that's the name of it. And the chorus says, life's evening sun is sinking low. A few more days and I must go to meet the deeds that I have done, where there will be no setting sun. Now that's hard, so I'm going to give you a line it out. Can I say, life's evening sun is sinking low, and you'll say, life's evening sun is sinking low. Few more days and I must go, a few more days, and I must go to meet the deeds that I have done, to meet the deeds that I have done. Be no setting sun where there will be no setting sun.
Good, and we'll get on just fine. Tony talked a little bit about my folks, Anne and Frank Warner, who set out to look for old songs in still rural America back in the 40s and found great bunches of them. And 10 years ago, my brother and I went down to the Library of Congress and recorded a lot of the songs that they had donated there and digitally recorded these old discs and tapes and brought out a couple of albums. I have one of them here, but I want to warn you about it, you know. Buy that kind of thing at your peril. You have to be extremely interested in old, weird America. The great sounds of wonderful people, old, you know, born in 1880, who were singing in 1948 and who were remembering songs from their grandparents. It's wonderful stuff, but it's not necessarily to do the dishes by. You know what I mean? Okay, to our song, and thanks for singing with me tonight. Each day I'll do some noble deed by helping those who are in need. My life on earth is but a span, so I will do the best I can. Life's evening sun is sinking low. A few more days and I must go, a few more days. I must go to meet the deeds that I have done, to meet the deeds that I have done. Be no setting sun where there will be no setting sun. To be a child of God each day, my light must shine along the way. I'll sing his praise while ages roll, and try to help some troubled soul. Life's evening sun is sinking low. Few more days, a few more days. I must go to meet the deeds that I have done, to meet the deeds that I have done, where there will be no setting sun. while traveling down life's weary road. I'll try to lift some traveler's load. I'll try to turn his night to day, make flowers bloom along the way. Life's evening sun is sinking low. A few more days, a few more days, and I must go to meet the deeds that I have done, to meet the deeds that I have done, where there will be no setting sun. The only life that can endure is one that's kind and good and pure. And so for God I'll take my stand and try to lend a helping hand. Life's evening sun is sinking low. A few more days and I must go to meet the deeds that I have done, where there will be no setting sun.
Hi, everyone. My name is Corey DiMario, and I am yet another musician that lives here in town, if you don't know me. I think I know most of you, at least a good portion of you. When we sit around on the committee and we decide who's going to come, who we're going to ask to come and be a part of this for the past few years, normally the thing has always been to ask people to come and basically do what they do, like Jeff. Say, we want you to be yourself and do your thing for the fine people of Brattleboro. But this year, Keith had another idea. He thought there's all these great musicians in town that don't get a chance to play together that often. They don't get a chance because we're all touring, we're all traveling around doing our own thing. So Keith sort of organized a sort of forced collaboration that's going to now become a Northern Roots tradition. Hopefully every year we'll have one ensemble that is sort of put together in a less than organic way. But we hope it's very, very good nonetheless. We hope that they do it. Yeah. So the other thing is that John. Right. So the other thing is that because there's so much traditional music in town, we refer to traditional music as trad. And John Potter from The Reformer, I think, once referred to Brattleboro as Traddleboro. So we call this ensemble Traddleboro. It's Andy Davis, Lissa Schneckenberger, Becky Tracy, and another guest coming on shortly, so make them welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Those were tunes that that Lissa has played in some form in the past together, and I've always wanted to really learn that first tune, so it was a really great opportunity. And the first tune, you noticed, it kind of settled on a couple parts and then went to three more parts. There were five parts in the first tune, and it's called the Dion Quintuplets. Actually, in French, they say les cinq jumelles, which is the five twins. And they were a big deal. They were born in 1934, and they were the first quintuplets to survive. And people actually paid money to go see them. So it's pretty wild. We're going to play jigs now.
The Mouse in the Cupboard and Bert Ferguson. So this next tune is a waltz. Starts off a little dreamy. It's a waltz I wrote for my daughter, Emma, who's out there somewhere. Emma, are you out there? We were out at Star Island, which is a sort of set of rocks just off the coast of New Hampshire, more rocks off the coast of New Hampshire, which is mostly rocks too. And one afternoon, there was a music thing going out there, and there was a room with the sun coming in and the harbor and the boats drifting around, and my daughter was just playing in the room and I was playing at the piano, and this got started.
See these lights?
You don't worry about tuning accordions.
We're going to do a last medley of the same tune. We'll start with Money Musk as the Scottish version with a Strathspey, and then we're going to go into the New England version of Money Musk, which is a reel. And there's actually two different kinds of dances that go along with each type of tune. And we're going to get our friend out to help us with this particular medley. Please welcome Dan Houghton on the pipes.
tidbit of information, the name Monimotsk, it's a town just up in, I think it's in Angus, up in sort of the northeast of Scotland, and it translates from the Gaelic as the strong scented bog or the strong scented moor. I hesitate to say stinking, but you know that could potentially apply.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hello. I hope you all had a satisfactory break. Welcome back to the second half. This has been a real pleasure to spend the day with all of you and have such a great time playing music and singing together and everything else. So I'm here to introduce the first act of the second half. You got to hear them a little bit in the first half playing with Sarah. Owen and Ellie Marshall are originally from Vermont, and they have recently relocated to Portland, Maine. And I've had the chance to play with them and hang out with them a bunch over the past couple of years at the Maine Fiddle Camp, and it's always been a real pleasure to hear what they're into. Every time I see them, there's new tunes they're excited about, and often for Owen, a new instrument that he's just purchased on eBay. So you guys are in for a real treat. And I should also say, Owen has a CD out there in the lobby with a band called The Press Gang, a really awesome Irish trio. So you can definitely check that out after the show. And so now, as a way of introduction, I'm just going to sing you two very quick little theme songs. Ellie Marshall plays the fiddle. Ellie Marshall plays the fiddle. Owen Marshall has strands of golden hair. Owen Marshall is tall just like a bear. Please welcome Ellie and Owen.
Hi. I did, in fact, just buy this bouzouki here on eBay this week. There are many instruments that are called bouzoukis. This is the true bouzouki. It has a bowl back. Also, some of the finest sticker inlay in the world can purchase. This instrument was $300. It came from Istanbul. I love it. It actually got lost in the tracking process. Whenever I buy an instrument, I get the tracking number. I'm just like obsessed tracking it. And my sister Ellie here was, I was just kind of like, where'd it go? It's gone. And she's like, well, it's probably been seized because they're using it as a drug mule, I guess.
No!
So, but it's here. Thank you.
Thank you. The first tune there was Shamrock Hill, which is one of my very favorite tunes. And then the second one was called Gathering Sheep. And the last one was called High Road to Glen. Also one of my very favorite tunes. And now it's time for Jigs.
Please welcome our good friend, Corey DeMario. I get really excited when I get the chance to play banjo. I'm playing banjo now, so I'm a little excited. I'm going to tune my banjo.
Now I'm excited.
Corey, you were supposed to tune this when you brought it out.
No, I told Owen I would be his banjo tech, but yeah. The banjo, it's no longer a source of shame.
Four jigs. Thank you.
Big hand for Corey DeMario.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. It is now my great honor to have Sarah Blair join us on stage.
For those of you who don't know, Sarah was Ellie's fiddle teacher, and Ellie and I grew up playing music together, and hands down, Sarah is the biggest influence in our musical, in our family, in our musical background. So Ellie and I love Sarah. We're really, really happy.
And I love you guys. I totally do.
All right, so we're going to play some more reels.
The first one's actually called Tripping Down the Stairs. And we were staying at our friends Ethan and Anna's house, and their house is a death trap. If you see them in town, they're not here this weekend, but if you see them, I almost died this morning.
I saw it all happen.
Yeah, I lost my footing, and I pretty much just tried to wedge myself into everything that I could to not die.
I think Owen's life passed before Ellie's eyes.
Yeah, I think it did.
Thank you.
Hello out there. Now for something slightly different. This is Lydia Ivins and Bruce Sagan. Lydia is from Turner's Falls and Bruce is from Ann Arbor, Michigan. And they will be playing some Norwegian and Swedish music on a myriad of instruments. And I'm counting on the fact that they've already tuned, because if not, there are many strings. And you know what that means. So the traditions that they're playing from are old and quite exacting. And they have, you have to study this, you know, this music to play it right. But then you have them also coming up with some really unexpected things of their own, including tunes that they've written, that they have actually have a CD out there that has their tunes that they've written in the style of this traditional music. And I've known Bruce to be quite a wild man at parties and gatherings at Ashokan, and never know what kind of unexpected things he will be doing with great passion. So are you finished?
Yep.
They're trying not to talk.
We're trying to hurry.
They're trying to hurry, right. So anyway, I will let them continue on with the rest. Lydia Ivins and Bruce Sagan.
So that was a polska. Saying polska in Sweden is like saying jig or reel in Ireland. It's what they do. And that was a polska in the style of the village of Bingsjö, which is from Dalarna, which is the so-called folklore province of Sweden. But it's a fairly recent tune because I wrote it for my wife on the occasion of a recent birthday. And I love her, and I told her we were going to play it tonight. Next we're going to do a traditional tune that comes from Buda, which is a village only a few kilometers away from Bingsjö, but you'll see it's completely different in its style. So all polskas are in 3-4, and this one you heard it was kind of like raining notes, and it was very even. Buda, they don't dance polska that way at all. It's very swoopy, and because of that, the three beats in the measure are of different lengths. So if you find yourself having trouble tapping your foot, it's not you, it's the music. So this is Piril Polskan from Buda.
Switches instruments, one before me, and we move to Norway, where there is a tradition of solo playing on the hardingfela, or hardanger fiddle, from the Hardanger region of Norway, which, as you see, has a lot of strings. Maybe you can't see. It has the usual number of bowed strings and then a little fleet of sympathetics. Bruce is a master of sympathetic strings. And the dance tradition for this tune is a men's solo dance. It's a sort of show-offy macho thing that involves a lot of gymnastics and culminating in kicking the man's hat is held on a broomstick at about head height, and he gets to spiral and kick it off the broomstick, and it's the last part of the performance. If he misses, he gets to try again. It's actually really fun to watch the hauling competition because everybody from about 5 or 6 year old boys on up is doing it. So it's a great tradition. How are you doing? A tune.
Okay, so now it's my talk. Actually, we'll trade off as we both switch instruments to the nyckelharpa, which is, or keyed fiddle, which is the national instrument of Sweden. And as you can see, it has keys. It's all keyed up. And you press. Okay. Good. Let me turn this one off just in case it's me. And it has a bunch of sympathetic strings again that we don't play on. They just resonate and hum along, at least if they're in tune. And we'll play you a couple of tunes on this to end. The first one is a tune that was composed by a fellow named Peter Blue, who lives in upstate New York. And he's an emergency medical technician. And you're still working? You're fine. Okay, can you take over talking while I change?
Peter Blue is an emergency medical technician.
Very smooth.
In Oneonta, and this is one of the tunes he wrote for patients he cared for, and she is one of the ones who unfortunately didn't make it, and I think you can kind of hear in the tune, it's kind of a sort of a sad tune. So Bruce has really adopted this one, and we put it on our record with his really cool arrangement. So. You like it too?
Yes, you can take it home if you like it.
Thank you.
Thanks. Well, we're going to do one more, and then there's going to be the finale. Just don't go away. That's the biggest and best part. This one is another traditional tune called Fem Tulan, because of it has five tones at the beginning, and you'll hear this little run. And it's what's called a sleng bolska.
I just want to remind you that all of the performers this evening and throughout the day perform here at the Northern Roots Festival free. They don't ask for compensation. They don't get any compensation. Just if you haven't already visited the CD table, please consider doing that on your way out. Also, please remember, if you're interested in keeping up with BMC events in general, and traditional music events produced through and by the BMC, please sign up on the email list. We'll be sending out some links to the Reformer and to the BMC web Facebook page for some photographs. There's been a lot of great photographs taken today. And if you'd like to sort of see some of that again, then that's a good reason to sign up on the email list. I'd like to call out our performers one more time out to the stage here for you to enjoy and appreciate all these folks. We have Jeff Warner, Tony Barron, Sarah Blair, Andy Davis, Jesse Gagne-Hall, Ellie Marshall, Becky Tracy, Lydia Ivins, Dan Houghton, Bruce Sagan, Lissa Schneckenberger, Owen Marshall, Corey DiMario, David Cantini.
And Keith Murphy.
Thank you very much. Thank you. We're going to end off with a song here. I hope you'll join us on the chorus. It's a great chorus song, Rolling Home to Old New England. Call all hands to man the capstan. See the cables running clear. Heave away and with a will, boys. For New England we will steer.
Rolling home, rolling. The girl you love most dearly, she's been constant, firm and true. She will clasp you to her bosom, all her fondest vows renew. Rolling home, rolling home. Rolling home across the sea, rolling home to old New England, rolling home, dear land to thee.
Up aloft and in the rigging blows a wild and furious gale, like a monsoon in the springtime, filling out each well-known sail.
Rolling home, rolling home, rolling home across the sea, rolling home to old New England, rolling home, dear land to me, and we'll sing in joyful chorus through the watches of the night.
We'll sight the shore of old New England when the gray dawn brings the rolling home, rolling home, rolling home across the sea, rolling home to old New England, rolling home.
good.